Billy. Long time ago, Guttu and Chinky resided somewhere in a city with their parents. Both of them celebrated every festival with fun. But being kids, their parents never allowed them to play Festival of Colors, Holi. But this time, Chinky and Guttu decided that, Chinky, this time anyhow, we will convince Mom and Dad that they should allow us to play Holi. Yep, Guttu, this time for sure we will play and celebrate Holi. Both of them went to their parents and said, Mom and Dad, now we are grown-ups, so you should allow us to play colorful Holi. But you always play colorful Holi. Not like that. This time we ourselves will play and celebrate Holi. You always apply a bit color on our forehead and this time we won't celebrate like that. On this, their parents looked at each other, they thought for a while and said, Alright, this time you can play Holi with colors.
But you guys better take care of yourselves.
Yay! This time we will celebrate Holi with colors.
Next day in the morning, both of them got ready to play Holi.
Mom, happy Holi!
Mom, give colors to us. We will play with them.
Hey, are you colors?
And they started playing with colors. Suddenly, someone rang the doorbell. On opening the door, they saw Mr. Sharma there with his wife. They came with colors.
Happy Holi!
Then the kids saw Mr. Sharma's daughter, Sona, standing beside him. They stepped forward to apply color on her.
It's time for Holi! Let's play colorful Holi!
It's time for Holi! Let's play colorful Holi!
But Sona stopped them by gesture of her hands.
Please, don't apply color on me. I don't want to play Holi at all. I don't like to play with colors.
On this, Guttu and Chinky saw each other and smiled.
She doesn't play with colors.
But we do play with colors.
And finally, they applied color on Sona.
It's time for Holi! Let's play colorful Holi!
And Sona started crying after getting colored.
Mommy! Papa! See what they've done to me!
Mr. Sharma went away with his wife and daughter, but Chinky and Guttu wanted to play more Holi.
Chinky, with whom do we play Holi now?
Yeah, on whom will we apply colors now?
And then Chinky's eyes fell on her pet dog, Tommy.
Brother, Tommy, come let's play Holi with him.
And both of them started playing Holi with Tommy.
It's time for Holi! Let's play colorful Holi!
And while playing, some color went inside Tommy's eyes and he started barking loudly and cried. On hearing Tommy's crying, the parents came and after seeing his condition, they got very angry.
Chinky, Guttu, what have you done?
First, you forcefully applied color on Sona, now on Tommy.
On seeing their anger, they both started crying.
Mom! We were just playing Holi, that's it.
Why are you scolding us?
On seeing them crying, their parents calmed down.
Don't cry, kids. Actually, the fault is ours. We didn't tell you the rules of playing Festival of Holi.
Rules?
Yes, rules.
First rule of Holi is that we should never play Holi forcefully with anyone.
And second is that the skin of animals is very soft and sensitive too. And the color can go inside their eyes. Therefore, we should not play Holi with them too.
Got it? Mom and Dad,
we will always remember these rules.
To all the kids, while playing Holi, please do remember and follow these rules. And for the sake of your pleasure, Please do not harm any other creature.
Happy Holi!
If there is water, then there is tomorrow. It was 22nd March. Mishra sir was not present in the class. Gattu, Chinky and whole class was enjoying. They were having fun by throwing the water from their water bottles on each other.
Yeet! Throw some more water. Make everyone wet. No one should be left dry. Empty all the bottles.
The whole class was busy having fun when Mishra sir entered. Everyone quieted and took their places.
Hurry, Gattu, stand up. Why were you making noise?
Sorry, sir. Rang Panchami is coming. And it is a holiday. So we can't celebrate it with each other. So we thought we will celebrate it today with water.
Hearing this, Mishra sir said,
Kids, Rang Panchami is festival of colors and not water. You all have emptied your water bottles. What would you do if you are thirsty?
No problem, sir. Our school has many water coolers. We will drink from it.
And if there is no water in the coolers?
It is impossible, sir.
It is happening, son. The thing is, today there is no water in any of the coolers and they are being cleaned.
Hearing this, Gattu and whole class was scared.
Shit, from where we will get water now? All the bottles are empty.
You should have thought about it before. Sit down.
Hari and Gattu sat down. Mishra sir continued,
Kids, after oxygen, water is the next thing that we need to survive. We can survive for few days without eating, but we can't survive without water for long.
That is why water is called life. I have read the slogan, if there is a water, there is a life, on many walls.
Yes, water is life. There is no future without water. We read these slogans on the walls, but still throw water on each other for fun. So, am I right?
Kids were embarrassed hearing this.
Kids, do you know why I am telling you this today? Because today is 22nd March. It is celebrated as Water Day throughout the world. And on that occasion, water tanks are being cleaned.
Then Hari said,
Sir, I am thirsty. There is no water in the bottle. Now what?
Hari, you wasted all the water. Now you have to tolerate it. Only then you will know its worth.
Hari was sad hearing this.
Kids, as I have already told you, there is only 3% water on the earth that is drinkable. Population is increasing, rain is decreasing, and water is scarce. People are fighting over it, do you know?
Just then Chinky said,
Yes, sir. During the vacation, we visited our grandparents. We saw many ladies fighting near a water tanker. One village gets only one tanker.
Yes, it is the story of many villages, where the rain is less or there is no rivers and ponds. Women have to walk long distance for water. We live in a city and we get water from tap. We have lots of water. That doesn't mean we have the right to waste it. We should use the water very carefully. We have to save water. Shouldn't pollute the source of water like rivers and ponds. And most important is, plant more trees.
So, I have an idea to save water and use it in right way.
Very good. What is it?
Sir, after school while going home, we waste the water from water bottle by throwing it on each other or throwing it away. But if we give this water to the plant in school campus, then water will not be wasted and it will help trees to grow. And then we will get more water.
Hearing Chinky's idea, Mishra sir was very happy.
Very good. This is a very nice idea. So children, what did you learn today?
That we have to use water carefully and should not waste water because it is important for life and without it, there is no life.
Very good, dear. Hari, did you understand the worth of water now?
Yes, sir. It looks like if I had not wasted bottles water, how nice it would be. I would not have to be thirsty. Now I know the value of water, sir.
Very good. Now there is no need to be thirsty. I have some water. Here, drink this.
Hari went to Mishra sir and drank the water. He felt relief as soon as he drank water. This way, Mishra sir taught whole the class that how important the water is, and everyone pledged not to waste water anymore.